warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So my name is Hakimi Akmal. So today my group, that is group 5, will present about optimizing the method execution, a comprehensive SOLIDWORKS simulation study. Next we move to our group members. So for the first one is Muhammad Hasif bin Abdul Rahim. Next we have Muhammad Hisham bin Muhammad Ajaran. Next we have me, Jason Hakimi Akmal bin Rahimi. And my last group members is Iskandar Zulkarnain bin Azizi. First, we move to chapter 1, that is introduction. We move to subchapter number 1, that is method extraction. So for the first one is the process overview. So method extraction involve forcing a billet or slug of metal through a die of process to produce object with a set cross-sectional profile. The result is a long piece with uniform cross-section, which can be a cut to length or further process. Next, we have the products that been produced from metal extraction, consists of pipes, rods, and structural parts. So the material that used to produce this product commonly use magnesium, copper, steel, and aluminium. And for the last one is the application. So it is widely used in industry such as electronics, automotive, aerospace and construction, especially for producing lightweight parts with high strength weight to ratios. So we have 5 types of metal extraction. So for the first one is the direct extrusion, and the second one is indirect extrusion. After that, number 3 and number 4, we have hot extrusion and cold extrusion. This process same as direct extrusion, but the process use cold temperature and hot temperature. And the last one is the impact extraction. We move to the last chapter of introduction. So for the objective, we have 2 objectives here. So for the first one, we have to achieve to stimulate the model relate to extrusion process in the solid work, and then we have a second objective. We have analysis the model stress, displacement, and strain value using the solid work software.
Assalamualaikum and hi, my name is Iskandar Zulkarnain. My metric number is 8N210035, and our group will discuss about the extrusion process, and I will present what the chapter 2, which is the literature review. For the literature review, it will cover 3 major topics, which is extrusion process, additive manufacturing based on extrusion process, and lastly the suitable material. For the first one is the extrusion process. The extrusion process is a manufacturing technique where a material, usually plastic, metal or rubber, is heated until it becomes soft and then forced through a mold or die to create long, continuous shapes with a consistent cross-section. The material is pushed through the die by a screw or ram in the extruder machine. When it exits the die, the material is cooled and solidified into the desired shape, such a pipe, profile or sheets. And lastly, this method is efficient for producing large quantity of uniform product and is widely used in industry for making everything from window frame or automotive part. For the next one is the additive manufacturing based on extrusion process. This chapter will cover 3 types different of process, which is the filament based type, the syringe or plunger based type, and lastly the screw based type. For the first one is the filament based type. The extrusion using filament based material pattern was initially granted to Straitase. Extrusion technology is used in this widely used 3D printing approach because it is safe process, require little labor, and use inexpensive component. And lastly, this type is identical to that one of the roller shape thruster because the filament resemble the formation of a wire. For the next one is the syringe or the plunger based type. The tube, which consists of a powder and binder mixture, is meant to be placed into the extruder, which use cartridge that resemble cavities. A component used to force the substance into the heater is the plunger. In contrast, the heater is a part that has the ability to heat the substance, allowing it to melt and flow easily down to the nozzle. Lastly, this kind is the same as plunger shape extruder because of its roll-like shape. The last one is the screw-based type. Extrusion based on screw is not all that unlike from other form of extrusion. Granule feedstock is the material that enter the system. Because of the method is more consistent and secure, it is thought to be the most stable. Additionally, the material will be disappear to the nozzle in an ideal manner. Lastly, in addition to being the most order, the system is also to be the most stable. For the last chapter for the literature review is about suitable material. The feedstock or initial material for the process is a uniform blend of metal of ceramic, powder and a multi-component binder. Powder of metal and ceramic are utilized as a solid loading to get the feedstock ready. Powder properties include mean particle size distribution, particle shape, specific surface area and chemical composition. Determine whether or not a certain powder is suitable for the additive manufacturing process. And lastly, one advantage of the multimodal particle distribution is that it may lead to higher solid loading, which is then reduce sintering distortion and increase sintered density. That's all for me. Thank you.
For the chapter 3, the methodology of the simulation extraction. This is the methodology flowchart of the simulation extraction progress. First, we begin with the literature review, and then we go to the geometry design. In the geometry design, we have 4 parts in this extraction progress. First, we have ramp, die, metal workpiece, and last but not least, container. And then we go to the mesh generation, and then we go to the solid work. We create the geometry design on the solid work, and then we have 2 options. If the if the design was successful, we can running the simulation, and then we can get the result and discussion. And if the geometry design is failed, we must recreate the design. And then for next methodology is the geometry design. This is the specification of the geometry design of the parts in the extraction progress. First, we have 4 components in this part: metal workpiece, ramp, die and container. And then we extract with the diameter and the height. This is the measurement of this. After we make the geometry design, we make the fixed geometry in this solid work to make sure the extraction die and the structure have been support. And then to make sure the high pressure and the strain without deforming of this model. And then the function of the fixed geometry is to make sure the model strong and well designed to ensure the consistent and high quality extraction result. For this extraction progress, we have 2 type material that we use in this simulation. For the die or ramp, we make of the alloy steel. And then for the metal workpiece, we use the aluminium bronze. The reason we choose the alloy steel for the die and the puncher, due to the high strain, hardness, wear resistant, it has also a ability to the withstand the with the high pressure and the repetitive strain without deforming. For the aluminium bronze, we choose because the high tensile strength, corrosion resistant, wear resistant, and suitability for application requiring strong. And then for next methodology, on the simulation, we put the force on this solid work extraction progress with the force 9,806,650 Newton that we use to push the material to the die and mold it to appropriate cross-sectional profile. And then we took overcome the material resistance and ensure the continuous flow through through the die. It also important on the force simulation because we got to understanding how the pressure and force variation affect material flow characteristic to ensure the product quality, and then to make the axial pressure replicate that the ram pushing action to the material extraction through the die, and last but not least to the pressure at the die input indicates the force necessary to commence the material flow. For next methodology is the mesh meshing generation. Mesh meshing is the creation of the extraction progress that break down the complex geometry of the extraction and build it to the small component. It is important to the reliable simulation result and influence the program as approximation material behavior under various condition. And then for the mesh production in the simulation, we begin with the specifying mesh size and type, and then we got to the based on geometry desire and the level detail, and then we use the mesh production to ensure the expected stress concentration or material flow change the suitability of the refine. The quality of mesh we can describe is determine the element shape and size distribution. It also to directly impact the accuracy of the extraction findings, such as the stress distribution, deformation and temperature gradient. For the mesh meshing refining, first we got to archive the excellent simulation accuracy while the maintaining computational efficiency. This is the goal of the methodology that aim to the objective of this progress. And then the streamline production process of this goal is to improve product uniformly, meet the high quality standard and ensure the finished extract component are differently and effective in their intended use. It also build in high efficient and optimize the design and manage feature with the precise cross-sectional profile.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Isham Muhammad Zalan. My meeting number is CN210113. Okay, today I will present about the chapter 4, result and discussion. Okay, for the first discussion and the result, we're going to the stress of workpiece. Okay, the figure show the result of the workpiece for the stress. For the discussion, the minimum stress is 6.448 Newton meter at node 553, and the maximum stress is 2.056 Newton meter at node 1933. For the color scale, blue is the lowest stress and the high and red is the highest stress. Okay, arrow indicate load application for the constraints. Deformation scale, okay, 0.8765 for better visualization. If not at the 1933 is near a fixed or high constraint area, it might be experience higher stress due to the reduction of movement. Okay, the higher stress constraint at node 1933 is likely due to a combination of geometry feature, material properties, loading condition, boundary condition, mesh quality, and deformation behavior. Okay, next we're going to the second discussion and the result. For the next figure show the displacement of the workpiece that we have run. Okay, for the minimum displacement is 0.00 millimeter at node 1, and maximum displacement is 3.844 millimeter at node 1955. Color scale blue for the lower displacement and the red is the higher displacement. Okay, arrow indicate load application of the constraints. deformation scale 0.87654 for the better visualization. Address this concern through design change such as optimize the geometry, refine material for properties, adjust load application or improving mesh quality can lead to a more robust and reliable design. For the last result and discussion, we going to the strain. The figure show the strain of the workpiece after we run the model. For the minimum equivalent strain is 5.424 at element 5,332, and the maximum equivalent strain is at 1.265 at element 5,618. The deformation scale applied was 0.8765 and the global value range was 0.0542447 to 1012-6511. Okay, the visual represent color green arrow and mark strain point. Okay, ensure clear the strain distribution throughout the cylinder structure. The support placement and model constraint affect strain distribution. Okay, fit or height constraint area show lower strain, free region experience height strain. Okay, the factor like geometry, feature, material properties, loading condition, boundary condition, mesh quality and deformation behavior can address height strain level. Okay, that's all for me for discussion and result. I will pass for the next presentation. Thank you.
Okay, next we move to the chapter 5, that is conclusion. Okay, lastly we move to the conclusion. So we have 5 elements here for the conclusion, that is goal of SOLIDWORKS, optimization benefits, process reliability, cost and development efficiency, and last one is cost and development efficiency. So for the first one, goal of using SOLIDWORKS is the we can simulate a metal extraction process. Then we can analyze the model stress, displacement and stress value from the SOLIDWORKS software. Next, we have optimization benefits. So the first one is improve an understanding of process dynamic, and then accurate simulation leading to reliable and high quality products. Next, we move to the number 3 is process reliability. So the identification of potential extrusion system failure can be located. And then analysis of stress and displacement data prior to real production. Next, we have cost and development efficiency. So this experiment, we can eliminate of the need for physical prototypes and then can reduction in material waste. And lastly, for the cost and development efficiency, we can encourage our creativity to test new materials virtually and then increase customization and sophisticated product development. Okay, that's all for the conclusion. That's all from us. Thank you and bye-bye.